members charged with crime. Let's get straight to the now. It's Kimberly Craig. She's live in Lincoln Park. So, Kim, what is this cat owner alleging?
Carolyn, Cassandra Johnson believes her cat was assaulted by the owner here. Now, that person not only works for All Pets Grooming here on Dix, he owns the place. Johnson brought her cat in last Wednesday, picked her up about 6 hours later, and soon realized something was wrong.
I picked her up in her carrier and brought her home, and she doesn't like the car, so the crying I just thought was because we were in the car. Once I got her home and opened the carrier, she came out and was limping and then kind of went and laid down.
Cassandra Johnson is talking to us and Lincoln Park Police about what she fears was no accident at All Pets Grooming in Lincoln Park. She says Roxy's condition worsened through the night. So what happened? Coming up on Action News at 6 o'clock, you'll hear from John, the owner and groomer himself, who denies harming the cat.
I was afraid I was going to have her put to sleep.
And coming up at 6 o'clock, you won't just hear from the owner. You'll also hear someone else's scathing complaint that was filed with the Better Business Bureau. For now, reporting live in Lincoln Park, Kimberly Craig for the Now Detroit.
All right, Kim, thank you so much for the live report. We'll look for your reports on later editions of Action News. Meantime, let's check in with Chris Stewart for the latest on our headlines.
Confidence in self-driving cars going down. Yeah, you can blame a series of high-profile crashes. So today we're looking at just how many of us are afraid, how these car makers are trying to win us back. Also, dozens of companies say they're hiking prices on us. Have you noticed this yet? What gives? We're going to get you some answers today. And with Toys R Us wrapping up its liquidation sales, TSO parents are marking the end of an era with their children. And you know the TSA dogs that you see at the airport? Well, they're named after some pretty amazing people. A little later in our lineup, you're going to see just exactly why their names are so fitting. Really cool story coming up today.
Results on mercury levels in school water. Right now, students and staff are waiting for word on when their schools will reopen in the Rochester district. A class experiment in Van Hoosen Middle School in Rochester Hills found high levels of mercury in water samples from the school and two creeks. The district canceled classes yesterday and today at Van Hoosen and Rochester High, which is right next door. Arizona State University tested the samples and found mercury levels at 28 times the limit for being safe. The professor who did the testing says people around the world send him water samples to test all the time. The city of Rochester sent that water to a certified lab for testing to get its own results. And the mayor says he will speak as soon as that information is available. We'll certainly keep you posted. And we'll be taking a closer look at this in today's big story ahead on Action News at 5. Amira David joins us now with a sneak peek. Amira?
Most people think you can get rid of contaminants by boiling the water, but what if there's mercury? Coming up at 5 in the big story, why experts say that actually could make it worse.
All right, Amira, thank you so much. We certainly look forward to that. Right now, Detroit police and the FBI are searching for a body in a murder investigation from 10 years ago. They started digging this morning at a site near Albion and Lapin. On Detroit's east side, you are looking at live pictures from Chapter 7 over the big dig site right now. Investigators tell us they received a tip that a murder victim was possibly buried in the area. We're told they're looking for a black male between the ages of 18 and 24. Coming up at 5, when investigators on the ground are revealing about this murder dating back to 2008. All right, let's get you outside now for a live look over Mount Clemens. Most of the rain has moved out, but you still might need your umbrella tonight. 7 First Alert Chief Meteorologist Dave Rexroth is here with a look at a chance for some showers this evening, right?
Even a rumble of thunder just